Hello everyone, today we are going to see the numericals based on the spiral gear. In previous video, we already seen the helical gear terminology used in helical gear, spiral gear, again the center distance of spiral gears, okay. Next is what efficiency of spiral gear. Again, today we are going to see the numerical which is based on the derivation, that is what formula we derived, that is what efficiency of spiral gear and the center distance between the two spiral gears. Myself, Mr. Y.Y. Kamble, Assistant Professor, Mech Engineering Department, SITC OE, EDRAV. So today we are going to see the numerical. So see, this is what numerical. The statement of numerical is that, I am just going to reach, okay. A pair of spiral gears is required to connect two shafts 175 mm apart. The shaft angle being 70 degree, the velocity ratio is to be 1.5 S to Y, and faster wheel having 80 teeth and pitch circle diameter of 100 mm. Find the spiral angle, okay, angles for each wheel. That means we are going to find out the alpha 1, alpha 2. If the torque on the faster wheel is 75 newton meter, find the axial thrust on each shaft neglecting friction. Okay, so this is problem. Okay, I just read out this problem. I just once again, okay, by splitting the sentences, and I will read slowly. Okay, so just see here. A pair of spiral gears is required to connect two shafts 175 mm apart. Okay, so there is a distance between these two spiral gear is what, 175 mm, okay, and the angle being 70 degree, that is what angle is given, that is theta is given 70 degree. The velocity ratio is 1.5 to 1, the velocity ratio is given, that is 1.5. okay, now next is what, the faster wheel is having 80 teeth and P circle diameter is 100 mm. That means a faster wheel, that means the driver will be there, okay. The faster wheel having 80 teeth, that means number of teeth on the faster wheel, that is what 80, okay. The P circle diameter, okay, of the faster, that is 100 mm. Now next is what, find the spiral angles of each wheel. That is what first finding is, that find the spiral angles of each wheel. That means we have to find out the alpha 1 and alpha 2. These are the spiral angles or helix angle, okay. So this is what for wheel 1 and for wheel 2, that is what alpha 1 and alpha 2. Next is what, if the torque on the faster wheel is 75 newton meter, okay, so torque is given on the faster wheel, that is what 75 newton meter. Find the axial thrust on each shaft neglecting friction. That means they ask, that is what axial thrust on each wheel, that is what FA1 and FA2, okay, on each wheel, okay, neglecting friction. We are going to neglect the friction and we are going to find out the these two value. So first thing is that, write down whatever data is given in the problem. So see here, whatever data given, write down, okay. The first thing is that what they given, that is center distance is given, that is what the two gears are apart from 175 mm, so that is what length L is given, that is 175 mm, that is what converted into meter, 0.175 meter, okay. Again next is what given, angle is given, that is what theta is equal to 70 degree, so theta is equal to what, 70 degree. Next is given what, velocity ratio is 1.5 to 1, that is what they are given, that is what N2 by N1 or N1 by N2, that is 1.5 divided by 1, that means 1:1, that is nothing but what, gear ratio G is equal to 1.5, okay. So gear ratio is given. Next, what they given, the faster wheel is having 80 teeth, that is what T2, the faster wheel here T1 and T2, they consider T2, that is what faster wheel T2 is equal to what, 80 teeth, okay. Next is what, again they are given P circle diameter, PCD is given, that is 100 mm for the faster wheel, that is D2 is equal to 100 mm, that is what this convert into meter, that is 0.1 meter, okay. That convert into radius, R2 is equal to what, 0.05 meter, okay. Now next, again they are given, that is what torque, see here, torque on the faster wheel, that is what 75 newton meter. So this is what the torque on faster wheel, that is what 75 newton meter. So these are the given data. So find out the each term one by one. So first thing is what, spiral gears or spiral angles of each wheel, of the spiral gear. Let assume alpha 1 is equal to what? Spiral angle for slower wheel, and alpha 2 is equal to spiral angle for faster wheel. That is what here alpha 1, that is what spiral angle for slower wheel, and this alpha 2 is nothing but what? Spiral angle for faster wheel. Okay, now we know that the velocity ratio, that is what, N2 by N1 is equal to G. Okay, now they are given N2 by N1 is equal to, I will write here again, N2 by N1 is equal to 1.5:1. So this is nothing but what? Gear ratio G. Again, we know that N2 by N1 is equal to what? T1 by T2 is equal to G. They are given here 1.5. Okay, so see here, next, number of teeth on slower wheel. Okay, so in the number of teeth on faster wheel, that is what T2 is given, that is what 80. Okay, we know that T1 divided by T2 is equal to G. So we have the value of G. So therefore T1 is equal to what? T2 into 1.5. So see here, this is what? T2 into 1.5. That means T2 is given, that is what? 80 into 1.5. So T1 is equal to what? 120. Number of teeth on T1. Okay, so we know that the center distance between shafts, that is L, is given. The L is nothing but what? Again, the formula to find out L is equal to what? D1 plus D2 divided by 2. Okay, so L is given, that is what? 175 mm converted into meter, that is 0.175 meter is equal to what? D1 plus D2 divided by 2. So D1, we don't know D1, but D2 is given, that is what? 100. Okay, that is what? 0.1. okay, so divided by 2. So we have the value of this. Okay, we have this. So find out the D1. So what will be the D1? D1 is equal to what? 2 into 0.175 minus 0.1. So we got here D1 is equal to what? 0.25 meter. So this is what a D1. So, and next is what? We have the formula, that is what? D2 by D1 is equal to T2 cos of alpha 1 divided by T1 into cos of alpha 2. So see here, we have the value of D2, we have the value of D1. See here, we have the value of D2, we have the value of D1, we have the value of T2, we have the value of T1. So we have to find out the alpha 1 and alpha 2. So put the value of this D1, D2, D1, T2, T1. So put the value, that is what? D2 is equal to what? 0.1 divided by D1, that is what? 0.25 is equal to T2, that is what? 100 into cos of alpha 1 divided by T1 cos of alpha 2, that is what? 120. We have the value of this T1, that is what? 120 cos of alpha 2. So this 80 divided by 120, that is 2 divided by 40. 2 is 80, 43 is 122. So it becomes 2/3 cos of alpha 1, 2 times cos of alpha 1 divided by 3 into cos of alpha 2 is equal to 0.1 divided by 0.25. So by calculation we got here, so cos of alpha 1 divided by cos of alpha 2 is equal to this 0.1 into 3 and this 0.25 into 2. So from this, put the values in calculator and find out the values. So what we got here, cos of alpha 1 divided by cos of alpha 2 is equal to 0.6. this is what the value. We have the ratio of cos of alpha 1 divided by cos of alpha 2 is equal to 0.6. okay, so see here, or we can also say that cos of alpha 1 is equal to 0.6 times of cos of alpha 2. That means we can write down here in terms of cos of alpha 1 or cos of alpha 2. We can find out the value of cos of alpha 1 in terms of cos of alpha 2, or we can find out the cos of alpha 2 value in terms of alpha 1. So we can write here cos of alpha 1 is equal to 0.6 into cos of alpha 2. Okay, this is what equation number 1. Okay, we know that again alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is equal to theta, that is angle made by these two spiral gears, that is theta. This theta is nothing but what? Alpha 1 plus alpha 2, that means angle of the gear 1 or wheel 1 plus angle of gear 2. So alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is equal to theta. Again in problem theta is given, that is what? 70 degree. So simply we can write here alpha 2 is equal to 70 minus alpha 1. So simply the thing is that alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is equal to 70. So we can write here alpha 2 is equal to 70 minus alpha 1. Okay, so see here, this can be written here. Okay, so substituting value, this value alpha 2, substituting this value in equation number 1, that is what previous equation. Okay, so this equation becomes cos of alpha 1 is equal to 0.6 cos of 70 degree minus alpha 1. So simply 0.6 cos 70 cos alpha 1 plus sin 70 sin alpha 1. This is what the formula I have written here. Cos of A minus B, that is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So by using this formula, this is what a cos A minus B. So by this, if we splitting this formula, that is what defactorization formula will be there. We got this value. This is what a cos of 70 cos alpha 1 plus sin 70 sin alpha 1. Okay, so we have the value, put the value. This is what cos 70 and sin 70 in calci. We get the values. Okay, so see here, this point six cos of 70, 0.6 into cos of 70 into cos alpha 1, 0.6 into cos 70, we got here value, that is what 0.2052 into cos of alpha 1. Again this sin 70, okay, into this 0.6, so what we got here, 0.5638 into sin of alpha 1. Okay, so we got the value here. Okay, so see here, from this value we can find out here. Okay, from this value, both terms here is what is equal to what, cos of alpha 1, sorry, I will write here cos of alpha 1 is equal to this term. So here is cos alpha 1, here is cos alpha 1, so get common here. Okay, so keep this term in one side. Okay, so cos of alpha 1 minus 0.2052 into cos of alpha 1 is equal to 0.5638 into sin of alpha 1. Okay, so by putting here, okay, so from this subtraction, what we got here, 0.7948 cos of alpha 1 is equal to 0.5638 into sin of alpha 1. Now from this equation, in right left hand side, cos of alpha 1 will be there, in right side sin of alpha 1 will be there. Again the constant terms, these two constant terms will be there. From this equation we can find out tan of alpha 1, and next is what, alpha 1 is equal to what, tan inverse of something. Okay, so tan of alpha 1 is nothing but what, sin of alpha 1 divided by cos of alpha 1. Okay, so is equal to what, 0.7948 divided by 0.5638. got here tan of alpha 1 is equal to 1.4097. okay, so we got here value, tan of alpha 1 is equal to 1.4097. okay, this is what tan of alpha 1. So simply alpha 1 is equal to what, tan inverse of this constant value, that is 1.40. okay, so what we got here, alpha 1 is equal to what, 54.65 degree. Okay, so similarly by putting this value, we got here, this is alpha 1 plus alpha 2 is equal to what, 70 degree. So alpha 2 is nothing but what, 70 minus alpha 1. So put the value here of this alpha 1, put the value of this alpha, into this here. Okay, so we got here alpha 2 is equal to what, 70 degree minus 54.65 degree is equal to what, 15.35 degree. This is what alpha 2. So see here, we got here value alpha 1 and alpha 2. This is what our first finding, the first finding asked in the numerical. Okay, this is what our first finding. Okay, now next finding is that we are going to see, that is what they asked, what axial thrust on the each wheel. Okay, that means we have to find out the FA1 and FA2, that is what, axial thrust on wheel 1 and axial thrust on wheel 2. So axial thrust on each shaft, we know that torque is equal to tangential force into P circle radius. Okay, so torque is nothing but what, F into R. Okay, so F is nothing but what, tangential force, R is what, radius. Okay, so see here, tangential force at faster wheel, first thing is that tangential force at faster wheel, F2 is equal to torque on faster wheel divided by P circle radius. Okay, that is what, R2. So F2 is equal to, simply their torque is given, that is what, 75 divided by 0.0 0.05, therefore F2 is equal to what? 1500 newton. Okay, so this is what a value of F2. A normal reaction at point of contact, this Rn is equal to what? F2 divided by cos of alpha 2. This Rn is equal to what? F2, that is what? Tangential force divided by cos of alpha 2. So we have the value of F2, we have the value of alpha 2. So put the value here, that is what? F2 is equal to what? 1500 into cos of this alpha 2 is what? 15.35. So we got here value, that is what? Rn, that is what? Rn is equal to what? 1556 newton. Okay, so this is what a normal reaction and point of contact. So we know that axial thrust on the shaft of slower wheel, now axial thrust on the shaft of slower wheel, that's F A1 is equal to what? Rn into sine of alpha 1. That's why for this formula here Rn will be there, that's why we find out the Rn value of normal reaction, that is Rn. Okay, so F A1 is equal to Rn into sine of alpha 1. Okay, so F1 is equal to what? Sine of alpha 1, Rn into sine of alpha 1. We have the value of Rn, we have the value of alpha 1. So, okay, so put the value, that is what? Rn is equal to what? 1556 into sine of 54.65. So put this value, in calci, okay, and calculate this term. So we got here FA1, that is what? Axial thrust force on the gear 1. Okay, that is what? Slower gear, that is equal to what? 1269 newton, that is what? F A1 is equal to what? 1269 newton. Okay, similarly next thing is that we are going to find out the axial thrust on the shaft of faster wheel. Now next thing is that we are going to see that what? Axial thrust on the faster wheel, that is what? F A2. So F A2, A2 stands for the faster wheel, A for axial thrust. Okay, so see here, F A2, their formula is what? Rn minus alpha sine alpha 2. Okay, so in that here Rn we already find out here. Okay, this alpha 2 we already find out. Okay, so put the values here. Okay, so values is what? 1556 into sine of 15.35. so put this value in calci, okay, and calculate this term. So we got here that F A2 is equal to what? 412 newton. So this is what? F A2. So this is what our finding, that is what? First finding is that alpha 1 and alpha 2, and next is what? Axial thrust force on slower wheel and larger wheel. That means we already find out all the findings. Okay, so this is what the numerical. Okay, so very simple numerical will be there. Okay, so findings, first thing is that just read out the problem, next thing is that write down whatever data is given, and next find out the whatever findings, stress out the whatever findings they asked, and solve accordingly. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. In next lecture we will see another numerical. Thank you.